Hello. God bless all of you as we come now to the fourth Sunday of Easter. Fourth Sunday of Easter is traditionally Good Shepherd Sunday. The Gospels are usually taken from John in the A, B, and C cycle. There's a three-year cycle that changes. First year A, second year B, third year C. We're now in C. So the reading we have is, so to speak, what's left over from John that was not used in A and B, from the Gospel of John. In the first reading, the Acts of the Apostles, Paul and Barnabas go out into the outside of parameters of Israel and the Jewish world there, and appeal to the Jews that are living outside in the diaspora, outside of Israel and Judea and Palestine. And they appeal first of all to the Jews because the Jews are the chosen people. But many of the Jews reject, and violently in some cases reject, this call to follow Jesus as the Messiah and as God. So, in turn, Paul and Barnabas bring the message of salvation that has been rejected by the Jews to the Gentiles. Since you reject it and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. That's a quote that's about halfway through the first reading of the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 13, verses 14, and then 43 to 52. I have made you a light to the Gentiles, that you may be an instrument of salvation to the ends of the world. Jesus is the light to the Gentiles. The Gentiles were delighted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who are destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread it throughout the region. The Gentiles are receptive. The Jews reject them and cause a lot of trouble. The last sentence, the disciples were filled with joy in the Holy Spirit. If anything is to truly be accomplished, it has to be the not so much our work, but the work of God through us. Yeah, only what is really rooted in God and God's work himself coming through us, coming through others, through whom, whatever, whoever, it has to be the work of God, is then it's going to have be of true worth. So filled with joy to see that God was working through them. Then we go on to that gospel, very short, from St. John. My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. Notice this theme of eternal life from the Acts of the Apostles and continued again in the gospel. He can bring us to eternal life. If we are not followers of the Good Shepherd, we do not become his obedient and loyal sheep, surrendering our will to his will. Then we're on our way to eternal destruction. Only God, our pastor, our loving, caring pastor, shepherd us who say yes to being his sheep, can we find eternal life. Human nature is going to revolt against belonging to anything like this, where we really belong to the Lord. To be his sheep means to belong to the Lord. But he has the means. We on our own do not. Now, we're not, it's going to be hard to convince people of that. We just have to let the work of the Spirit bear fruit within us so that we surrender that natural desire to do it on our own, to be our own selves without God, to surrender that desire and say, yes, Lord, only in you, through you, and with you. Without you, it's all worthless. This is a tremendous issue, and we have to confront it daily. Because our human spirit, with the help of the devil, of course, never gives up. We have to constantly go back to the Holy Spirit. Dear Lord, help me to belong to you. And by belonging to you, I'm going to be my best self. By being loyal, obedient sheep of God's flock, letting the Lord pasture us, appealing to the Lord to pasture us, that we have everything we need. Remember that last line in the parable of the prodigal son, where the elder son complains to the father. You gave everything to him, and look, he threw it all away, that the prodigal son. The father says, everything I have belongs to you. That's what God is saying. Everything he has belongs to us. His sheep. His loyal, obedient sheep. When we surrender our will to his, it's his love that is poured into us. And he has only the best, the eternal best, to give to us. On to the book of Revelations that's here. I, John, had a vision of a great multitude, which no one could count from every nation, race, people, and tongue. In other words, the call to follow Jesus as our pastor is universal, not exclusive. To all who wish to follow him, he has his arms open to us. Going a little further down. Then one of the elders said to me, these are the ones, the ones who are in heaven, who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Really, what Book of Revelation, sometimes called the Book of Apocalypse, is appealing to all those who are living at the time in persecution, those who are about to be martyred. They're saying to them, everything will be well. It may seem that you lose it all, that the enemy has destroyed us, but in the end, look at your reward. You will gain heaven, and you will gain it forever. When you have washed your robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. When those saints were martyred, they have become the followers of the Lord in heaven. For this reason, they stand before God's throne and worship him day and night in his temple. How wondrous it is to see our God as he truly is, to the extent that we are enabled. We can do that because we are limited beings. But nonetheless, to be able to see him to the extent that we can and worship him. For the Lamb, down further, who is the center of the throne, will shepherd them. Again, that theme of the shepherd. Lead them to the springs of life-giving water. God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. That's really addressing this in this particular time to those who are going through terrible times, suffering greatly at the hands of their persecutors and those who treat them extremely badly and murder them. May the Lord lead us one day to heaven. May we be his faithful followers. He will enable us to do that. His grace will be adequate for us if we constantly go back to him. In the midst of a world that often is hostile to him, in the midst of a natural spirit within each one of us that can be hostile to him, we go back to him and plead with him, give me the grace that I need to be a loyal and obedient follower of yours, true sheep of your flock.